So as I told you in the theory, that is the collection of the microwave source and the various apparatus required to do measure the parameters of this microwave source or do the analysis of this microwave source. These all together is called as microwave bench. So this device is called as microwave bench. So on this device, the first is a klystron source. First is an klystron source. Now this is a source which is generating a microwave signal, and we are using this source. We are using a specialized power supply, that is a klystron power supply. The settings of that power supply already we have seen. Now always we need to isolate the source from the output side, so there should not be any back reflection from the load side. So this is an isolator. You can see the arrow on the top of isolator. This arrow indicates like that, that is signal will flow only from input side to output side, no backward signal flow from output to input. Then next to the isolator, this is an frequency meter. It is used to measure the frequency of this signal. Now if you see this frequency meter, on this frequency meter there is a marking for the various numbers. These numbers are the frequency that we can read from the meter. The unit is in gigahertz. You can see two horizontal red lines and one vertical red line. So whatever the number in between the two horizontal red lines and intersected by a vertical red line, that will indicate the frequency. Now if you see, this is 8.24. So this is 8.24. That is the number in between these two red lines and intersected by this vertical red line. Number in between two horizontal red line and intersected by this vertical red line. This number is 8.24. So we can say that this is the reading of the meter, 8.24 gigahertz. This is a sample reading. We are not done any experiment. I'm just showing that is how to read out this frequency meter. That is whatever the number in between the two horizontal lines intersected by a vertical line, that is called as a frequency, and that is in gigahertz. Then next is a slotted line. If you see this slotted line is the device which is used to sense the maximas and minimas of the output signal. Now see, if we move this slotted line, then we can move this probe. So this is the probe which is inserted through this slot inside this waveguide. Okay, this is the slot made, and this is the probe which is inserted through this slot inside the waveguide. And this probe can be rotated from left to right by using this screw. Similarly, the position of the probe can be noted down by using this vernier caliper. So you can see this vernier caliper. This is the main scale. This is the auxiliary scale. So whenever we are reading this vernier caliper, we have to read like that. That is, the zero is crossing which number on main scale? For example, here we can say like this. That is, zero is crossing 15.8. So you can write the reading 15.8. Other than this, we have to see this 0 to 10 lines on the auxiliary scale, and which line is exactly matching with the main scale. That we have to see, which line is exactly matching on the main scale. So which line is exactly matching over here? This line is exactly matching. That is, 7 number line is exactly matching from 0 to 7 number line. This line is exactly matching to this line on the main scale. So we can write that is 15.87 centimeter is the probe position. So in that way we can note down the probe position by this slotted line. Then the next device that we are using, that is an SS tuner, that is called a slide screw tuner. Now this slide screw tuner is used to generate the impedance, variable impedance or variable load inside this at the output end of this waveguide. So this slide screw tuner, you can have this screw, and by rotating this screw, you can rotate or you can move, insert the plunger inside the waveguide, that will change the impedance, that will change the impedance of the signal, that will change the impedance of the signal, and that will change the, because the, there is a change in impedance, the amplitude of the signal is going to change. So this is a SS tuner. So initially we have to keep this SS tuner on 10 so that we don't want any mismatch of the impedance. Full signal should be transmitted to the output side. Okay, then the last one is a detector mount. So this detector mount is used to connect the signal to CRO. So this is a coupler, this is a coaxial coupler. This coaxial coupler is used to connect the coaxial cable to the waveguide. So the center conductor of the coaxial cable is inserted inside the waveguide, and this coaxial cable is connected to CRO, where we can see the modulated amplitude modulated signal generated by this reflex or the klystron source.